Innovation hinges on our ability to see things differently. Breaking boundaries and looking between the lines in an effort to solve some of the world's toughest challenges.
Hello, Build. I'm Dan Morris from the AI for Earth program here at Microsoft. AI for Earth's job is to put Microsoft cloud and AI tools to work for environmental sustainability. And today my goal is to get you excited about doing sustainability work on Azure. AI for Earth supports the sustainability community in three ways. We're a grants program, we're a data program, and we are a technology development program. Through our grants program, we support over 500 organizations all over the world with the resources they need to scale environmental research to the cloud. A great example of one of our grantees using AI and machine learning is an organization called WildMe, a nonprofit that makes open source software for wildlife population monitoring. And in particular, WildMe uses computer vision to accelerate the painstaking task of identifying individual animals in photos, which is really important to getting accurate population estimates for many species. And while this is a very challenging problem algorithmically, it's conceptually straightforward. Here's a picture of a whale shark, or a giraffe, or a zebra. Is this an individual animal that we've seen before? And even if machine learning can narrow it down to 5 of the thousands of animals in a database, this can profoundly amplify scientific productivity. For example, in the last 10 years, WildMe has identified more whale sharks than were recorded in the entire history of whale shark research before they showed up. To date, more than 10,000 individual sharks have been identified by over 8,000 citizen scientists and nearly 200 researchers, and that is a scale that just couldn't be achieved without vision-based acceleration. And like many of our grantees, WildMe makes their work available to the open source community. So if you want to get involved, check out WildMe on GitHub. Another organization we're proud to support is Conservation Science Partners, who do all kinds of amazing work at the intersection of data science and environmental monitoring. One of their recent projects is another great example of putting machine learning to work for conservation, using their open source framework for estimating forest mass from aerial and satellite images. So if processing huge volumes of images with machine learning is your bag, check out Conservation Science Partners' work on GitHub. And speaking of huge volumes of images, I mentioned that AI for Earth is also a data program. We host the large geospatial datasets that environmental science depends on, which can scale into the petabytes, especially when it comes to satellite and aerial imagery. And if you're a Python type, we also try hard to host developer-friendly Jupyter notebooks for each of the datasets we host, to get you started in the right direction and to get you making mesmerizing pictures of the Earth in just a few lines of code. And lastly, I mentioned that we're a technology development program too. Most of the work we do leverages machine learning to help environmental scientists, especially wildlife biologists, efficiently process the huge volumes of data that environmental surveys generate. Or in other words, we are here to help conservation folks spend less time clicking on images and more time planning conservation. All of our work in this area is open source, and our GitHub repo on processing images from motion-triggered wildlife cameras is a great place to get involved. We have open source models and code on our repo, and we also maintain a large collection of labeled data so you can try your hand at training your own models too. All of the work we do, through grants, data hosting, and technology development, comes together to put the cloud to work for environmental sustainability. And over the coming months, you'll see this work aggregated into a single landing point that bundles infrastructure, tools, and data into what we call a planetary computer. But we can't build it alone, and we need the help of our developer community. So please check out some of the open source projects we linked to today, and we look forward to merging your PRs.
Hinges on our ability to see things differently. Breaking boundaries and looking between the lines in an effort to solve some of the world's toughest challenges.